All right, so we're going to look at the new Marine Corps faction that's been added for squad. Just a brief overview. In the training range, see the top right, USMC, Marine Expeditionary Unit. First off, the thing I notice is that the Marines don't really get optics, which is kind of strange to me, and the implementation of the M16. It makes me wonder, with the developers, like, what timetable they're going with this faction. It seems odd that they have both the M27 added in, and then not giving Marines optics plus M16s. To me, it would have made more sense to have M4s be the primary, and then M27s being the special weapon you could get throughout the squad. That just would have made more sense to me. Like I said, it just seems like a weird, almost out of place time-wise, because if you look at the Army, U.S. Army faction, they're all pretty much all up to date with the most modern stuff they have, including like the M17 pistol and all the optics. And not giving optics is strange, because it's not like the Marine Corps doesn't have optics, unless we're looking at, like, I don't know, sometime around 2004, but in which case, why would we have the M27 to begin with? So that's my first, I guess, issue, just jumping into it. I do like that the medical slot is called a corpsman. That's a nice touch. I'm just going to grab the lat here and just kind of deploy, look at what we've got here. Just kind of see how this looks and feels. Oh, we do have the K-bar. That's nice. That's a nice touch. Alright, M16. Then with 3-round burst. Man, I suck. The model of the M16 is good. Like I said, it just doesn't make much sense why they would put the M16 with no optics as options a lot of the time. I think the class is still going to be fun. The faction is going to be fun to use. But it just seems like an odd design choice. Reload. Alright, let's try the hat out here. So the hat gets the M4, the M16. We have the spotting round, which is cool. If you don't know what the spotting round is for the small, pretty much it'll fire a tracer round. That should tell you where your rounds are going to land. So, let's see. Perfect. Up a little bit. Boom. Spot on. Now you switch to the anti-armor round, like that. And hopefully this should be on target. Awesome. That's a cool feature. I like that they did that. HEDP. Looks like for this roll, you only get one each. Let's see if the other one, you have more. So the only difference is you get an M16 and an M4 between the two? It's a little odd, but... should have at least given one of them an optic, like the guy with the M4 a holographic, or the guy with the M16 an AR or something. It seems weird. All right, we're gonna move on to the vehicles here right after this. Something that I noticed, I didn't check before. You can see the squad leader roles here. So, squad leader M16A4 with the grip and the tracers. A normal M16 with irons. And as some of you saw here, an M27 with irons. That's very strange. I don't know why you would have the M27 with irons. But you can, for some reason. So that's an interesting thing to note. Right, here at the vehicle section, you see the new vehicles. The LAV-25 for the Americans here. And next door, for the Amtrak's. Yep, the Amtrak's. Something real quick I noticed with the DMR. It's weird that you don't get a grenade with the marksman. I know that's like a squad balancing thing. I just find that odd that you don't at least get a frag, at least one frag grenade. Anyway, so we're gonna check out these vehicles here. Let's see if I can grab a crewman kit off of one of them. Role select. All right, so we're gonna try out the LAV real quick. It kind of seems to handle like the Australian one. I'm not really surprised there. It's probably just a literal reskin copy paste. Take this over to the range. We'll go through the seats. So we have the gunner seat, we have APS, high explosive incendiary, and a coax. So let's try this out. Yeah, pretty much exactly how I imagined it to. Oh, that's a quick. Seat. Nothing crazy. Is a co a 240G on top. That's an interesting note. With an optic. Not that it matters anyway, because you're exposed, and as soon as you get into the seat, you're gonna get fucking shot and killed anyway. I do like that they put an optic on the top of this one, because I know for like, was the Abrams, the 240 on top doesn't have an optic, so that's nice. And then for your passenger seats. Oh, so you only have like three for your seats there? That's interesting. Okay. I'll take her back and grab the AAVs. So smoke generator. We can kind of really whip this thing around corners, huh? I imagine that the AAV is going to be a pain in the ass to drive, but we'll give it a shot. It's going to be slow. Oh, that's right, there's new Humvees too that I need to take a look at. Right. We have two AAVs. We have the command version and then the normal version. Oh, this thing actually gets up and goes, huh? All right. Oh, look at that. Oh, turning. Yep, turning in a track vehicle. But I'm actually surprised at how fast that kind of took off there. Smoke generator. I imagine the gunner on this is just going to be a 50 cal in Mark 19. If they even have the Mark 19, I'm not sure, but I'll back her up here. You have the Mark 19. Awesome. You see the ranging on the left for the 50 cal, and the ranging on the right for the Mark 19. I think this thing is actually going to be a really good APC to use. It's not going to be well armored. I'm sure one RPG is going to fucking disable it, like in real life. The Mark 19 alone is going to be awesome to use, and the ability to switch back and forth. Is a third commander seat here, but you can't see a single thing. And then passenger seats. The thing should be able to fit pretty much a whole squad in it, which is nice. The Amtrak really is a battle bus. It's just that it handles kind of like shit. It's not really well armored, and it's not really made to be taken into combat. But it is amphibious, so we get that going for it. It'll get you there to where you need to go, but I wouldn't really count on it being a much of a fire support vehicle. We're gonna look at the other Amtrak too here in just a second. I don't think there's anything different about it except for it doesn't have a gun on top. Just slam into this LAV. Oh, it's a logistics vehicle. Okay. I see. That's very interesting. So this is your logi vehicle. Amphibious. Okay. That's interesting. I like that, actually. That's very cool. Then we get the Matt Vs. Nothing different about those at all. However, we get these cool things. It's the up-armored Humvees. This one with the crow. This one's the open top. Open top, that's very cool. Like the detail in the back here, the ammo cans spread around. Kind of like just trash and paper laying around here. The laptop for the commander. Fuel cans, bags in the back. That's a nice detail. I like that. This one's a weird choice. It's an up-armored Humvee, but they removed the armor from it. So I guess you could sit in the back if you wanted to, but it doesn't really, I don't understand why you would want an up-armored Humvee that doesn't have armor on it. Because the driver's exposed from the back now, like, from the sides. Like, you're just, like, if they had the swivel mounts where you could shoot out of it, that would be very cool. But you don't. So I don't understand why you would want this. I guess there's a couple extra room in the back you can sit out of, but I don't know, it doesn't seem very useful at all to me. Anything else down here? Just normal logi trucks. Yeah, normal logi trucks. Alright, well, we'll come back with the amphibious part of it here in just a moment. Alright, so here is the Pacific training ground. I guess we're the 31st Mew, because we're in the Pacific. That makes sense. Versus a Russian battalion tactical group. They suck. I like the LHD in the background here, and it looks like we actually spawn on the LHD, which is very, very cool. Let's see if this is the lower or the upper deck. Let's find out. Upper deck. All right. Oh, right. Helicopters. Yeah, I'll get to that here in a second. Are we wearing Woody's now? We are wearing Woody's camo. That's very cool that the camo. You have both camos in. All right, so this is the UH-1. It's the Marine Corps' primary utility helicopter. Looks like it has a 240 on both sides. Let me just check the other side. Yep. Should fit about 10 dudes in it. That's really cool. I do enjoy the Huey a lot. I don't know what the purpose of these Humvees are, if they're gonna add sling loading soon, so you can sling load Humvees under the helicopter. What ship are we on? Does it say? Anywhere? Two? What is, I don't know what two, I don't know which one the two is. I'm sorry. Feel free to roast me. We're gonna head down to the well deck. This is a really cool addition. I like this a lot. It reminds me of some of the Battlefield 3 and 4 maps that had stuff like this, where you went ship to shore. Was it like Noshar Canal? And, there's the other one, Battlefield 3, I can't think of right now. I see rib boats. Let's take a look at these rib boats here. So we have a rib with a Browning M2, 240 on the other side. This is a logistics one, it looks like. That's very sweet. And this is just gonna be a normal one. No, it's more logistics. Okay. Alright, we're gonna try to take this one with the M2 out. Let's see how we launch this. Do we just. Oh, very nice. Wow, if they I all right, this I like. This is cool. I'm a fan of this. Where am I going here? Honestly, if this was a map, that would be pretty fucking ridiculous. I would play it though, I'd play the hell out of it. Is there anywhere to come to shore here? It's a little too steep. You can kind of handbrake in this, which is pretty nice. So you can really rip this rib around corners here if you wanted to. Literally just come to shore Battlefield style. Side. I like the ammo cases underneath, that's a nice touch. One on this side. I know I'm looking in the air here, but. Oh, so you do get quite a few seats with this. Alright. Wow. You can fit an entire squad in this thing, huh? Very nice. Very cool. Question is, when you beach this, can you? You push it out, is the question. I guess, really, if you're operating the rib, you have a driver and a gunner. I'm assuming that I haven't looked at any of the maps yet. And you just ferry people across. You don't really beach it like this, Battlefield style, but. See if I can unbeach it here. Yeah. Kind of. All right.
Check this island out.
Okay, so it's more of a training ground up here. Once again, we have M1A1 Abrams's. I don't see the LAVs up here. I guess the LAVs are back there. Alright, let's respawn back at the ship. The LHD. Or is it an LHA? I don't know. Let's see, let me just grab a. Let's try the automatic rifleman out. We'll spawn at the. I believe this is the well deck down here in this spawn, right? Yes, it is. Something I notice, there's no Amtraks. I don't know if that's. Just because, if there's a reason for that. But it's weird that there's no Amtraks here. Let me grab a crewman kit and we'll, see how fast she is. Ooh, that's an unsettling noise. I hate that noise. Tossed around by the waves a little bit here. So the waves really are a big factor here in your movement, because I'm getting kind of thrown around here by these things. If you're seasick, or get seasick easily, close your eyes during the island invasion portion of the match. just overall, I do like that they're added the amphibious stuff. Obviously, I like that they added the Marine Corps. I really just don't like the move with iron sights for the majority of the faction. You're going to be at a disadvantage to, a lot of the factions, pretty much. You might as well be insurgency at that point. I don't know. It just doesn't make any sense to me. I am hoping that with the addition of this faction, we're going to get the, what are they calling it? Like, the Pacific Coalition, whatever it is they're calling it. The not China faction. I think that'll be really cool to have maps like this that are long islands that we have to fight across, especially for like an invasion mode. For AAS and RAAS, it's gonna be a little wonky if there's a huge distance between the islands, but I think having more maps with more amphibious capabilities set in the Pacific would be really cool. Have the Marines and the not Chinese faction fighting. So I'm hopeful for that in the future, and I'm really hoping that they, do something about the gear. Oh, for sure. Do something with the gear that the Marines have. It's so weird to me. Why does the Army get the, like, I don't know. This doesn't make any sense. Developers, please.